Students, today I'm explaining about identification of phenols. So in our previous class we learned completely about identification of alcohols through various tests in the laboratory. Okay, this is one of the important tests we will do for the identification of phenolic group in the laboratory. Okay, that is nothing but ferric chloride test. So ferric chloride formula FeCl3. Okay, we'll take this ferric chloride and we'll prepare the ferric chloride solution freshly. Okay, freshly prepared ferric chloride solution should be added to the phenolic solution. For whatever compound is given to you, that compound should be dissolved in water, then it is called as a compound solution. Okay, phenolic solution. So to this solution I'm adding ferric chloride solution which is freshly prepared, then you'll get a complex formation. Okay, this complex is violet in color. Violet color complex is formed along with hydrochloric acid as a product. So this violet color complex or purple color complex is nothing but indication of the phenol group in this particular solution. So even if you are taking cresol or salicylic acid or resorcinol, you will get violet or purple color in the test tube. Okay, so if you are taking catechol solution and if you are adding ferric chloride, then you'll get a green colored solution. Okay, so basing on colors we can identify which phenolic compound it is. So if you are getting violet or purple color, we can say that as a phenol or cresol or salicylic acid or resorcinol. Okay, if you are getting only green color, we can say that as a catechol. Okay, this is about the ferric chloride test, which is mainly useful to identify the phenolic group in the laboratory. Next, coming to the chemical properties of alcohols. Okay, already we know what is a chemical property. Chemical property is nothing but reaction of alcohols with new substance to produce a new products here. So these chemical properties are utilized as industrial applications to produce various products. Okay, so now let us see the first reaction by the dehydration of alcohols. By the dehydration of alcohols, we can produce alkenes. Okay, so here this dehydration is taking place in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid at 160 to 170 degrees centigrade. Here sulfuric acid is acting as a dehydrating agent. So we know already dehydration is nothing but removal of water molecule. So here in this ethanol, if I take ethanol, you can see hydrogen and OH. Okay, this OH coming out as a OH minus. When I break this bond, it is coming out as OH minus. This carbon gets positive charge. So here hydrogen comes out as H plus. So when I'm breaking, when I'm shifting this bond towards carbon, carbon gets negative charge, hydrogen gets positive charge. So this positively charged hydrogen and negatively charged OH minus hydroxide ion combine together to form H2O. So now this carbon is having negative charge, this carbon is having positive charge. So they together form a double bond here. Okay, so now ethanol is resulting in the formation of ethylene upon the dehydration process. So next we are taking the propanol, same reaction. Propanol and the presence of sulfuric acid, it is also leaving out the water molecule. From this carbon hydrogen is leaving and from this carbon OH minus is leaving. So it is forming a double bond here. So second carbon is getting a double bond, that is propene. Propene is forming along with the liberation of water molecule. So dehydration results in the formation of doubly bonded compounds, that is nothing but alkenes. Okay, next coming to oxidation. So oxidation definition already we know. What is oxidation? Oxidation is nothing but removal of hydrogens or addition of oxygens. Okay, so that process is taking place in the presence of oxidizing agents. So I'm taking certain oxidizing agents like chromic oxide, chromic trioxide, chromium trioxide and pyridinium chlorochromate. Okay, so here I'm taking the ethanol and I'm taking the chromium trioxide. So this acts as oxidizing agent and here oxidation is taking place. So what will happen in the first reaction? Ethanol is converting into acetaldehyde. That means here hydrogens are removed. So removal of hydrogens is nothing but oxidation. Next, I'm adding one more chromium trioxide. Then what will happen? One more oxygen addition is taking place. So CHO is converting into COOH. So acetaldehyde is converting into acetic acid. So ethanol upon oxidation producing acetic acid. So primary alcohols are producing acids upon oxidation. So we can restrict this oxidation second step by adding pyridinium chlorochromate, which is also an oxidizing agent. So this oxidizing agent, when we are adding to primary alcohols, it will give the product only aldehydes. Only aldehydes will form. So this pyridinium chlorochromate can restrict the formation of acid. It will do oxidation up to aldehyde. So here what will happen? CH2OH is converting into CHO. So removal of hydrogens is taking place. So it is also an oxidation process. So I'm adding again pyridinium chlorochromate to the secondary alcohol. So again secondary alcohol is converting into ketone. Okay, here also hydrogen removal is taking place. So we can call this process as a oxidation. Secondary alcohols in the presence of pyridinium chlorochromate converting into ketones. So coming to the tertiary alcohols. Tertiary alcohols will not undergo oxidation easily because there is the absence of hydrogen to this central carbon. So you can observe always the central carbon is having hydrogens. Those hydrogens are replacing with the oxygens. Those hydrogens are responsible for the oxidation. Here there is no hydrogen bonded to this carbon. Okay, hence tertiary alcohol resists the oxidation easily, so it won't undergo oxidation process. So this is about dehydration of alcohols and oxidation process of alcohols. Thank you.